If you want to sound great on Zoom, you can use a dynamic microphone, a conference speakerphone, a phone headset, a lavalier mic, or you can stick to the built-in microphone in your laptop, but that is probably the worst microphone you have. By the end of this video, you will know which type of microphone you should pick to upgrade your video conferencing setup. My name is Markus Seppälä, and on this channel, I help you engage better with your audience. And great audio is an excellent place to start. When I run workshops for my corporate clients to help them improve their video communication skills, audio is always one of the most important aspects. Here are the five different microphones that we're going to be comparing in this video. The phone headset and the lavalier mic are both about $20 each. The dynamic microphone comes in at around $70, and the conference speakerphone is around $200. Then there is, of course, the laptop microphone, which is free, and there's a good reason why it's free. So let's start there. This is an audio sample of the built-in microphone in my ThinkPad X250. Microphone check 1, 2, 1, 2. Microphone check 1, 2. In this sample, the Zoom automatic noise suppression is active. That was pretty terrible. And you can probably do better with a $20 phone headset. Here's mine. Let's take a listen. This is an audio sample of the Veho Sports phone headset. Microphone check 1, 2, 1, 2. Microphone check 1, 2. In this clip, the Zoom noise suppression is on automatic. That phone headset is not great, but I think it is better than the built-in microphone in my laptop. By the way, there's links to everything I'm talking about in the description below this video. There you can also pick up my free video conferencing checklist. Now let's move over to a better microphone, which is this $20 lavalier microphone. This is an audio sample of the BOYA BY-M1 lavalier mic. Microphone check 1, 2, 1, 2. Microphone check 1, 2. The Zoom noise suppression is on automatic in this clip. Has this been valuable to you so far? Hit the like button. Now let's try this $70 dynamic microphone, which is connected with a USB cable. This is an audio sample of the Samson Q2U USB dynamic microphone. Microphone check 1, 2, 1, 2. Microphone check 1, 2. In this sample, the noise suppression is active. Next up, we have this $200 conference speakerphone. You can connect this one either with a USB cable or with Bluetooth. In this sample, I'm using the Bluetooth connection. This is an audio sample of the Polycom Calisto 7200 connected via Bluetooth. Microphone check 1, 2, 1, 2. Microphone check 1, 2. In this clip, the Zoom noise suppression is set to automatic. Before we move over to my analysis of this comparison, let me tell you how I made this recording. All of the audio that you're hearing in these samples was recorded with Zoom on my laptop on the table there behind me. And the reason why I'm using Zoom is that I want to give you an authentic picture of what these microphones actually sound like on a Zoom call when Zoom does all of the processing that it does. The only audio processing I did was that I made sure that the volume was approximately the same in all these different samples. If you do want to find out more about any of these products, check out the links in the description below this video. There you can also pick up that video conferencing checklist that I mentioned. As you saw in this comparison, all of these microphones work, and they're definitely all better than using the built-in microphone in your laptop. Therefore, what I usually recommend to people is that if you're only going to upgrade one thing in your video conferencing setup, upgrade your microphone first. A phone headset is a great place to start because the quality is usually decent. Plus, you can actually use it with your phone as well. And using your smartphone for video conferencing is sometimes a very good choice because the camera is usually much better in your phone than in your laptop. Then we come to this lavalier mic, and the one that I used in my testing is the same one I'm using to record this video, this BOYA BY-M1 lavalier mic. This kind of connector, the headset connector that this one has, is going to work great with laptops and desktops, but it may cause you some problems in other settings. I made a whole video about it. If you want to check it out, click the card here above me or have a look at the links in the description below this video. Then we have the dynamic microphone, the Samson Q2U. And out of all of the microphones I've tested, this is the one that sounds the best. And I have two power tips for you relating to the Samson Q2U as well. Power tip number one is that you don't actually have to hold it directly in front of you. As you saw in that testing, I had it slightly to the side. It still works really great so long as it's pointed towards your mouth. This is an audio sample of the Samson Q2U dynamic USB microphone. In this sample, the automatic noise suppression has been switched off. This is an audio sample of the Samson Q2U USB dynamic microphone. In this sample, I have switched off the automatic noise suppression in Zoom. Hit like if you're getting some value from this video. And power tip number two is that it comes in two different bundles. And I wish I would have gotten the bigger bundle for the Samson Q2U. The bigger bundle includes this little extender that can raise up the microphone a little bit higher from the table. If you're sitting down like I was doing in my testing, that's not a problem because it was at the right height. But usually I do my video conferencing from my standing desk. So it would have been nice to have it a little bit higher up. Of course, I have another choice of getting an actual microphone arm for it instead. I have links to both of those bundles in the description below this video. Then we come to the Polycalisto 7200, this conference speakerphone. And out of all these different microphones, this is the most flexible. One, you can connect it either with a USB cable or with Bluetooth. And when you connect it with the cable, it's also charging the battery at the same time. Two, because it has this Bluetooth connection, you can also use it with your smartphone. And this works really well, either if you're doing video conferencing on your smartphone, but even for voice calls, the sound quality is really good. And the feedback that I've gotten from people that I've talked to with the Polycalisto 7200 has also been really great. And three, because it's a conference speakerphone designed for conference rooms, it works really well for hybrid meetings. So in hybrid meetings, you have people physically in a room together, and then you have other people joining the same meeting virtually with video conferencing. I've used it in my most recent hybrid meetings, and it works really well. I made a whole video about audio in hybrid meeting where this is definitely the best choice. Have a look at the link here above me for that video. In all of these clips, I have turned on the automatic background noise suppression in Zoom. For a comparison without background noise suppression, check out the video that I have linked in the description or click the card here above me. In just a moment, I'm going to jump over to my bonus tip that's going to take your video conferencing setup to the next level. But if you've been getting some value from this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. I post a new video here every Thursday, and they're all about helping you engage better with your audience, whether you're doing that on stage or on video. And here's that bonus tip. As you start upgrading your video conferencing setup, think of all the other things that you can do with that setup. For example, the setup that I'm using with my Canon M50 and this lavalier mic, I use that to record a stand-up comedy course. You can find it at comedyforbeginners.com. Another example is this Samson Q2U dynamic microphone. I have it connected via USB to my computer, but it also has this XLR connection. And this XLR connection is the type of connection that you need to connect it to a professional mixing desk. And what that means is that I could actually bring that microphone with me when I go perform at the comedy club. With a great audio setup, there's so many more things that you can do. For example, you can do a podcast, you can do live streaming or video production. So when you start upgrading your video conferencing setup, don't think about it only as a video conferencing setup. Think of it more as a video production studio. I mentioned earlier my corporate Zoom skills workshops. If you would like to help your team become better at video conferencing, you can book this workshop for your team. There's contact details in the description below this video. And if you want to get started for free, just pick up my free video conferencing checklist. There's a link to that as well. You can also improve your video conferencing right here on YouTube. Click or tap the screen right here for my full playlist of video conferencing tips. I cover everything from lighting to camera angle to video quality in that series, and they're all bite-sized clips covering specific skills so that you can level up your video conferencing setup.